Hello students, welcome back to my grammar class. In this class, we are going to solve cookbook exercise of singular and plural. And this is the second part, okay? And then, first we are going to recall about what is singular noun and plural noun. Okay, shall we start? See here. What is singular noun? Yes, a singular noun is tells us about one person, one place, one thing. Okay, we can simply say it is only one. Then what is plural noun? Yes, a plural noun tells us about two or more people, places or things. Okay, clear with that? And then we know that there are so many rules to convert singular into a plural form. Now we are going to rewrite these sentences changing the underlined nouns into the plural forms. Okay. In the sentences rewrite. And then we are going to change the underlined nouns. See here. Underlined nouns into the plural forms. All these underlined words are in a singular form, so that we are going to convert into a plural form. Okay, shall we start? See here. First question. I kept a green leaf between two pages of my book. I am going to repeat it again. I kept a green leaf between two pages of my book. So that first I am going to explain in Tamil. Then only we are going to convert it in plural form. See here. Now one green leaf வந்து இந்த ரெண்டு page bookல இருக்க ரெண்டு பேஜ்க்கு நடுவுல நான் ஒரு green leaf னா வச்சேன்னு சொல்றாங்க. So here which is an underlined word? Yes, leaf is a underlined word. So we have to check the last word. So L E A F. Okay, the word ends with F. So what you have to do? Yes, we have to drop this F and then we have to add V E S. Okay, have you remember the how to convert singular into the plural form rules? This comes under the third rule. Okay, if the singular word ends with F or FE, we have to drop that F and FE from the singular word and then we are going to add VES to make the plural form. So that how this sentence changes? See here, there is no changes in these words. Okay, only the changes happens in the underlined nouns. So I kept green. Okay, leaf changes into yes, leaves. So leaf here is a singular and leaves here is a plural. And then between two pages of my book. Okay, students, how do I understand the first sentence? See here, second sentence. I love the smell of fresh loaf. Okay, I love the smell of fresh loaf. Okay, students, what is loaf? Yes, bread paathukkeengala. Adhu vandhu cut panni neenga pieces ah paathukkeenga. Adhu neenga eppadi sollanum? Yeah, loaf of bread appdi sollana. Oru piece ku varum. Okay, adhu bread vandhu neenga paathukkeenga rectangle shape la irukum. Adhu vandhu neenga cut pannama irukkumbodhu we have to say it is a loaf. Okay, not only for bread, we can say for mass food quantities. And the mass food quantities with it, we can say loaf. Okay, clear with that? And then, I love the smell of fresh loaf. Here, this is an underlined word. Yes, loaf here is an underlined word. And the word ends with F. So, if the word ends with F, yes, we have to remove that F and then we have to add P-E-S. So, the sentence changes into I love the smell of fresh. See here, first step we have to remove that F. Remove means inga na the F na eduthra podu and then we are going to add yes. Okay, it changes into L O A V E S. Yes, so fresh loaf. See here, loaf here is a singular, loaf here is a plural. Clear with that? For the third one, the elf lives in my garden. The elf lives in my garden. Okay, students, how many of you watched the Smurf movie? And the part singla, kutti kuttiya persons varuvaangala. So, we can say elf ka small, kutti kuttiya ka people na solluva. Actually, it is a frog face. Okay, la, katti kadigal da idella. Loaf, elf vandu முன்னாடி அந்த கட்டு கதைகள் மோஸ்டா சொல்லிட்டு இருந்தாங்க, பட் அது வந்து ரியாலிட்டியில இல்ல. ஓகே, கிளியர் வித் தட். அண்ட் The elf lives in my garden. And the elf on the garden like water to come and sort of. That is the Tamil meaning for this sentence. Here, which is the underlined word? Yes, elf. The word ends with yeah. So it changes into E-L-B-E-S. We have to do that yeah, and then we have to add E-S. So the elf lives in my garden. Okay? Our students, have you understood first three exam sentences? See here, fourth sentence. My sister bought a new scarf. My sister bought a new scarf. Okay. So here, this is underlined word. Yes. Scarf here is an underlined word. The word ends with F. You know what to do. Yes, you have to add, you have to drop that F and then you have to add VES. So it changes into my sister brought a new scarf. Okay? Look at the last example. Put your things on the shelf. Okay? Put your things on the shelf. Okay? Shelf la oru things vachile appdi solraanga. So here, this is underlined word. Yes. Yeah? Shelf is an underlined word. So that the word ends with F. So what you have to do? Yes, same thing. You have to drop this F. This is the first step. Okay, if you drop that F, this is the first step. And then you have to add PES. It changes into shelves. Okay, clear with that. So the sentence changes into put your things on the shelf. Okay, here shelf is a singular and shelves is a plural. Okay, students, have you understood all these sentences? See here, now we are going to recall. Okay, what we have learned today. Yes. We are learning about the singular noun and the plural noun. And we have done the book back exercise. First, what is singular noun? Yes, a singular noun tells us about one person, one place, one animal and one thing. And then, what is plural noun? Yes, a plural noun tells us about two more people, person or things. And then, there are so many rules when we are converting singular into a plural form. Okay, we generally add yes to make the plural form. And then, if the word ends with yes, ch, yes, this, yes, such, and then x, o, we have to add es. And then if the word ends with f or fv, first thing you have to drop that f or fv from this word and then you have to add ves. Okay students, have you understood rules and regulations on the singular noun and plural noun? Okay students, see you in the next video. Thank you.